Well, there we have it. The Direct is finally announced. Again, we talked about the rumors and everything about a September 6th Direct a couple days ago, and here we are now going into tomorrow. We have a Direct on our hands, 35 minutes. Of course, Nintendo put this out in a tweet, as you're seeing here, 3 p.m. Pacific, 6 p.m. Eastern Time. That is an interesting time, by the way, as most of us are probably used to Nintendo Directs being morning slash, I guess, midday, usually around noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific, sometimes even earlier than that. It's interesting to see it kind of on the other side now at 6 p.m. Eastern Time, my time. So that's going to be fun. It's almost like they have some Japanese stuff to some Japanese-based games to announce, since that's going to be 7 a.m. in Japan, and of course that'll set up the rest of the day for them there, for anyone, covering it and everything. So, maybe that time actually has something to do with what they're going to show. It's interesting to think about. Now, you probably noticed in their tweet, they did mention the 3DS. I know people are freaking out. Oh no, 3DS. I don't think the 3DS is going to have a very large presence at this Direct. And we're going to kind of go into some of the predictions here. And there are some games that are already kind of floating around out there, and I'm not interested in putting them in this predictions video. Some of them will be a nice surprise, I guess. Look, here, you'll get one. It's the new Super Mario Bros. Game. I think that's going to be there. It seems obvious at this point. Everyone's talking about that one. So there's a freebie for you. That'll be shown. I think it's coming out this year. It'll probably be a 2018. I'm going to put it in November. Okay, we'll go November on that one. I think it could fit into the end of October if they want it to, but they could also drop it like in November, maybe a week before Pokemon or a week after Pokemon or something. It's Mario. It'll sell. As long as it's out by the holidays, no problems there. Now, instead, we're going to go over some games that I would like to see in the Direct, some that I don't think will be there, and I'm trying to come up with the available now announcement, as Nintendo likes to do this a lot, as we've seen several Directs in a row now where they say it's available now, whether it's Fortnite or Hollow Knight or demos. I have two in mind, and there's going to be another one that I'm not going to put in here. I think it'll surprise some people. It'll be fun. But there are two that I have an idea, and I'm hoping it's the case. So we'll go over that as well. And then, of course, we'll do our Reach prediction, which is really a character in Smash. So I think we'll have a character reveal at the end of it as well. So let's start with the games that I don't think are going to be here. I don't think Metroid Prime 4 will be here. I think that's a holiday 2019 game. I don't think Bayonetta 3 will be here. I don't think Animal Crossing will be here. And I don't think Yoshi is going to be here. I think Yoshi is going to kick off the year in like their January Direct that they typically do, or we'll get a January Direct kind of set up the rest of 2019, because I think Yoshi is going to be in kind of where that Kirby game was, Kirby Star Allies. I think it'll fit somewhere in there, like a February or March release, and then kind of get things rolling throughout the year, and then we'll probably roll into an Animal Crossing in the summertime. That, I think, is stuff that they'll really talk about and get into then. I think they want to do a lot of focusing on games that are coming up soon-ish. I say soon-ish because they probably will show some 2019 games. I could see Demon X Machina getting a release date here, possibly a January, February release date. That's very possible. But as for the typicals, the Metroid Prime 4, the Bayonetta 3, you could see Pikmin. Those are games I don't think will be here because I think they have plans for late next year, and they can work on those in directs down the road. We already know games like Metroid Prime 4 and Bayonetta 3 are in development. We don't really need to be shown it again and again and again, kind of string this along until we get to the inevitable holiday release lineup, which has, I assume, both of those. Instead, I think they're going to be mostly showing games that we can expect in the next 4 to 5 months. So I think for the 3DS, it's probably going to be maybe 2 or 3 games, and I think one of them will be the Persona Q2 localization information. I think we'll find out that it is coming west and other parts of the world, and they'll probably give us an idea of when we can expect that, a release date and whatnot, and maybe they'll talk more about the Bowser Inside Story port, and then maybe they have something else outside of the Luigi's Mansion stuff. Maybe they have like another game that they're gonna put on it. I don't think it's gonna be a ton of time. Like, so I think it's gonna be like, remember, I think the last Direct they did, they just rifled through. The last time the 3DS was there, they rifled through a bunch of 3DS games in less than 5 minutes. In fact, I think if it wasn't for the 3DS game, this would just be a half hour Direct straight up. Instead, it's 35 minutes. So 3DS stuff, I think, will be done quick. I think we'll get it out of the way in the beginning, and then we'll just cruise on to Switch stuff. And we know Square is going to be there because we keep hearing rumors. We see the Pocket Edition get leaked out. Yeah, I think Square is going to be a part of this Direct, and I think they're going to introduce, I know people are going to be kind of frustrated, Final Fantasy XV Pocket Edition. I'm almost 100% confident is going to the Switch. I think it's going to be revealed here, but I don't think that's the only thing that Square is going to bring. I think they are going to kind of go back into their back catalog games, and they're probably going to bring up some of their older Final Fantasies, like a Final Fantasy V, a 6. If they really wanted to make a big splash, you grab 7, 8, or 9. All of those have made their way to PC, and some have even made their way to cell phones, so a cell phone port would be easy. I think the Steam one's probably pretty straightforward as well. So if they want to make a big splash, grab one of the PS1 games that have never left Sony's consoles, bring it to the Switch. Otherwise, grab 5 or 6 and or 4 and just bring it over, and that'll be a nice little release lineup there of their older catalog on a portable Switch. Now, if they're going to be localizing Persona Q2, which we assume they will be, I think they're also going to bring a Persona game to the Switch. I think Atlas is going to be porting, and again, people might be frustrated about this, I think Persona 4 Golden is going to come over. I don't think it's going to be Persona 5, and I think Persona 4 Golden being on the Vita probably is an easier port job just to get that done and out. That might actually be what Ghostlight is currently working on, as we heard about, kind of that they are already working on a Switch game being ported over. Seems like a smaller project to get that done, considering it was already on mobile hardware with the Vita. So that is probably something they'd want to bring over, get some more sales out of that portable version. And I guess at that point, Atlas will continue moving forward with other games, but that seems like an easy one to just introduce here. Now, we already talked about New Super Mario Bros. U coming to the Switch. I think that's going to be one of the Wii U ports. I think the other one is going to be Wonderful 101. We've had nothing but teases for this game, and at first I thought it was just Kamiya trying to get the attention of Nintendo, but it continues on and on and on. And then it kind of stopped. I think Wonderful 101 is coming over. I think that's going to be another announcement. I think that's another this year announcement, although it could fall to next year. And that's one I'd like to see, because I completely missed that one on the Wii U. And I don't feel like going back to turn on my Wii U because of the Switch. I don't want to plug the Wii U back in. So I would like to see that come over, and that way I can just play it on the Switch and experience this game. But I could see that being another Wii U port. And I'm trying to figure out how many other Wii U ports they want to do, considering we're going to be going into the third year of the Switch's lifespan next year, you know, after next March, I mean third year. Do they want to really keep porting Wii U games into its third year? Because I feel like at some point you want to build this system's own identity and rather keep pulling from that Wii U library, because if you keep doing that, I don't think you're going to then port those again to the next system. So I think we're running out of time on these Wii U ports. So like the Wonderful 101, which definitely sold less than they wanted it to, I think would be an easy port job, and they'd probably get some pretty good sales out of it. They'd definitely be more interested in it than there was in the Wii U. Also, let's talk about some third-party support. I think we're going to get another third-party game that comes over that is going to be kind of a bit of that shock factor like we got with Doom and Wolfenstein. Probably not to that degree as leading up to that Direct from last year. No one thought a game like that could happen, and now we know a game like that can happen. So it's going to be less of a shock, but I do think something like a Fallout 4 would still kind of hit people like, wow, wait, Fallout 4 as a portable game as well? I think that's one that we could see show up, and I think that's one that could be coming out later on this year. That could also be a November release with Fallout 4. If that wouldn't work out, I could see them maybe grabbing a Dishonored collection like 1 and 2 and bringing that over, where 1 is on the cartridge and then 2 is a download. Or I guess they could try to get Prey working. That's another one. We already heard about Arkane Studios doing some Switch hiring. It's very possible that was to get it to the finish line. So we'll see. That would be a good third-party announcement there. Another good third-party announcement would be Overwatch. If Blizzard is on board with the Switch, as we see Diablo, which we assume Diablo is going to get a release date here as well. If they do something like Overwatch, remember last year Bethesda showed up with, we saw Doom, and then we saw Skyrim released within a week of each other. We could have something similar to that with a Diablo and an Overwatch, as Overwatch is more of a game that they want to get on a system and then have loot boxes and currency and stuff in-game, get them more money. I could see them releasing those close to each other, as Diablo will sell on its own, and then of course Overwatch has a massive fandom. Who wouldn't love to have Overwatch as a portable game? And that's something I could see happening as just something they could push together, even if it's like within a week or two of each other. I don't think that would affect sales, and they could, I think, do that. I think we do get that Metroid Prime Trilogy HD. I think that's a pretty easy announcement, and then a very easy sale. I think that could fit in similar to where the Bayonetta collection fit in. So that could be, I could see that being a January release, to be honest. That doesn't need to necessarily be out in the holidays to sell well. That's one that most Switch owners are going to go out and buy to get ready for Metroid Prime 4, especially if you're unfamiliar with the series. That's an easy one. They put it out, everyone rushes out and buys the thing because they can play it on their Switch. I would like to see them map everything to the control sticks as well as get that motion control. I know people like the motion control, but of course, if you're in handheld mode, you want to be able to use the sticks rather than have to move the system around like I was doing in Doom at one point. So I hope they have that fit into where it's traditional controls and then also gyro controls so you can choose. That seems like an easy one. And I think it's about time we got this HD Prime trilogy, and January, somewhere in there, it seems like a good month for it. Now we need to know more about this, of course, this online service that is coming down to the wire now. We need to know about this. And I think this is going to be a part of the Direct that maybe is like a 5 or 6 minute thing. I think they're going to talk about it a good bit, but then I think they're going to give us a place to go to learn more, like go to Nintendo Online or whatever and learn more about it. Maybe an app shows up or just a part of the store where you can learn more about it on your Switch. I don't know if they want to just sit down and lecture people on what the online service is going to be. I think we're going to get like a nice little infographic about it, and they're going to go over a few of the key points, and then we're going to move on. But I think we're going to find out the day that it's going to launch, which I think is the last week in September. I think it's going to go all the way to the end of September to when they're ready to launch it. But we'll get that release week. I couldn't tell you any other features that we could be getting. I could tell you things I'd like to see, like, you know, native voice chat, messaging, parties, you know, all the stuff that we'd like for quality of life on the Switch. I think they're going to keep pushing that app, and that's kind of the way it is, unfortunately. Maybe we'll find out more about those other NES games that keep getting talked about. Maybe they have something cool up their sleeve, like, oh yeah, and we're adding Super Nintendo games, and we're looking at GameCube support down the road. Here's the classic controller that you can now go out and buy. Things like that. But for now, we need to know the release date, and then we need to know a place to go to learn more about the service, because I'm sure that'll end up being a whole video that we have to do here, just kind of going over all the features of the online service after we learn about it. And then also, of course, we need to know what is available today. Tomorrow. What's going to be available tomorrow when the Direct happens and when it closes out? We've had this tradition almost now where Nintendo, at this point, always introduces something you can go buy right now. So I think one of them, or actually probably both of them, are going to be free-to-play things. So I think Warframe could drop tomorrow. That would be really cool. I haven't heard anything about it, but I think that'd be a really neat thing to do. It worked very well with Fortnite, right? Where Fortnite dropped and 2 million downloads happened in 24 hours. I don't think Warframe's going to have that same effect, but of course, people get really excited after they first see something and they learn they go buy it. Same thing happened with Hollow Knight, right? 250,000 downloads in like the first 2 weeks or something, and those were all purchases. So yeah, free-to-play thing, you just saw it, it looks pretty cool, you know, it's this action RPG MMO, yeah, I'm gonna go out and I'm just gonna download it and we'll play it. That would get a lot of initial downloads, and of course Nintendo gets money on all the microtransactions, so they definitely want to put a light on Warframe because that is just recurring revenue going forward. And then the other thing that I'm kind of figuring out, I think this is going to be a thing. Mega Man 11 was supposed to have a demo on September 4th. I know that because we talked about it on Newswave a while ago, and I've been looking forward to trying the game out, but it's nowhere to be found. It did not show up yesterday at all, despite places like True Achievements and places usually track these things, updating it in their servers. Nothing with the Mega Man 11 demo. I think because Capcom and Nintendo are pretty close on some of the Mega Man 11 marketing, as we see them have a whole special edition with an amiibo. I think they're going to announce it in this Direct. There's a demo available. Go get it right now, just like they did with Octopath, if you remember that. So I think tomorrow you're going to be able to download Warframe and you're going to be able to download Mega Man 11 for the demo to try out ahead of its October release. I hope that's what they do, because I want Mega Man 11 to do well. If it gets a nice little push with a demo and it's shown in the Direct, that will help it. And then, of course, we can get Mega Man X9 someday. And then, of course, we got to close out with a Smash character. The safe bet to me is Rex from Xenoblade Chronicles 2. I think that makes a lot of sense. If you want to go for the reach, this is like the biggest reach ever, probably. It might not sound like it to a lot of people, but I think it's a big reach because of the companies involved and the relationships that would have to happen. Banjo-Kazooie. Just Banjo coming over from the Banjo-Kazooie series and that being announced, that would be one of those big, whoa, what just happened things. Kind of like what happened with Cloud as one of those big, like, out-of-nowhere reveals. I know some people are pulling for it, just like people have been pulling for Rayman, but Banjo would be a good one to drop in there. He was well-known on the Nintendo 64. Rare seems open to people using the IP and everything, so that would be really cool to see. And Microsoft and Nintendo are close now, so I mean, why not? Let's do one of those crazy Smash reveals again and just drop Banjo in there. And those are my predictions for tomorrow's Direct. It's gonna be, like I said, 35 minutes, and I think they're gonna get through stuff pretty quickly, so I think there's gonna be some cool announcements in there. There are some that have been purposely left out of these predictions, so look forward to that. There's some stuff that's gonna be fun, and I think people are gonna enjoy it. I always tell people to keep their expectations low, you know, but I do think tomorrow's Direct is going to be a lot of fun based on the stuff going around right now. So get ready. We're going to be live streaming it here, and it's going to be awesome. I'm really looking forward to it. Guys, if you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit the like button. It really helps out. If not, hit the dislike and leave comments down below about what you want to see at the Direct tomorrow. Go ahead and leave that Mother 3 comment down below, because you know what? We've come this far, so why not? Mother 3 tomorrow, right? We'll see, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure you guys get subscribed as well with notifications on, so you know when I'll be live tomorrow and we can check out this Direct and see what we have, and I'll see you guys then.